So the chapter we were discussing, it's a chapter number 5, Risk Through Software. We discussed about the two types of the software. The first type of the software is the system software, in which the operating system will come. The second type of the software is the application software, which we are discussing. We see some of the examples of a system, application software. In this regard, we are also viewing this example of MS Excel. MS Excel is used to create, the spreadsheets. Spreadsheets are very much fast. They are faster than the calculator. Spreadsheets can be used to draw pie charts and bar charts as well. They are used to draw pie charts and bar charts. Spreadsheets are used to do. We see in the last class that we can make a total of all these things. In less than a second. So now moving towards the page number 39. Everybody open the page number 39. On the page number 39, the first line of the page is saying that an orderly collection of records and data stored in a computer is called database. So in this, we are going to discuss the fourth thing. What is the fourth thing we have? We discussed about MS Word. We discussed about MS Excel. Now we are discussing about MS Access. And there is one more thing. It's PowerPoint. We didn't discuss in the book, but in the class, we verbally discussed this thing. So if you make it a prominence, it will be look like this. So right now we are discussing the MS Access. MS Access is also the application software. MS Access is also the application software. Now an orderly connection of records. A record which are made on the order or data stored in a computer is called a database. For example, when you go to school to take admission, what do? When you go and wants to take admission in a school, what do? You go and give the fees and give your name, father name, and your address, everything for the record, so that these all the information are saved in the database to use it later. Now, okay, now orderly collection of records or data stored in a computer is called a database. We see the first line. Now moving towards the next one, let me add someone join the class right now.
Okay, so now we are seeing the MS Access. Database management program enable us to store, retrieve, and manage a large amount of data. The short form of database management program is DBMS. DB is from database. So ultimately, the short form of database is DB. The short form of database is DB. So Now my voice is clear to everyone.
Yes, sir. Before you.
Okay. So, an orderly collection of records or data stored in a computer is called database. When you go to take admission in hospital, in school, in anywhere, you just give your information. Why you give information? To make a record. You book a ticket on the airport. You give your name, father name, your telephone number. Why? To make a record. So, the orderly collection of records or data stored in a computer is called database. Database management programs or softwares. Program and software both are same. Database management programs or software allow us to store, retrieve, and manage a large amount of data. They allow us to store, retrieve, and manage. We can save the data in it. We can retrieve it. Retrieve means we can take it out. We can see the information. For example, you book a ticket 1 year back. You traveled and you came back. Now, airline wants to check what are the names of those passengers who traveled last year. So if they have a record, they can take it out. This taking it out make it a retrieve. They retrieve the data of previous years. So if they have a record, they can take it out. And database management system used to manage a large amount of data. Calculations are also going on in this. So database management system or programs allow us to save the data and manage a large amount of data in it. Then what we have, the next point is saying that Microsoft Access is a database management software. Microsoft Access is a database management software. Microsoft MS Access. MS Access. Microsoft Access is a database management software. So in this software, we manage the database or the data. So the example of a database is MS Excel. There are so many others. Now, it helps us to find data easily. Who helps us? Database management program or a software. Database management program or a software helps us to find data easily from a collection of related records and files. For example, in a class, there are 50 students. And we have to find out the name, for example, Ahmed. So now we have to read all the names. Okay, but it will take much time. So we can just find out the name by pressing some shortcut keys and with the help of some instructions. In database, there are some more other things than finding, which make the things easy to manage the database. So when you try to find out just by the name and you press the control F and write the name, the computer will find it out for yourself. For you, the computer will find it out the name. You don't need to read all the names. So same is the case with the MS Access. You just have to click on one or two buttons and just write a simple instruction to get the data from 500, 5,000 or 50,000 students. Less than a second, they will find it out. Because if the 50 students are in class, we can do it in 1 minute. But if there are 500 students are in the class, how we can find out the Ahmed? We have to read 500 name. And if there are 5,000 students, then it's nearly impossible. We just give this question to computer and computer will find it out. That computer work is done by the database management program. Our database management software find out the data from the database for us on our question. On our question, when we ask to database that find this name, find this address. So we are asking a question, and in database, it is called as a query or a query. Both pronunciations can work. Let me write the spelling. We see this word earlier also. It's a query. We give the query to database. In simple words, it's just a question. We give a question to database. So now database helps us to find data easily from a collection of related records because there are so many records in it and files. So computer can find it out easily. It also enable us, allow us to sort data and keep it up to date. So computer can sort the data. What is meant by the sort? Can anyone tell me the meaning of sort in the chat? What is meant by the sort? What do you think? What is sorting? I will tell you, but let's see. What is meant by the sort? What is meant by the sort? Let's see. Oh, very good. So, Rajatava, Albara Dori, Ahmadullah Meiman, Arhan, good. That's good. Sort, it's S-O-R-T. It's S-O-R-T, it's mentioned in your book. Here it is. Here it is mentioned. There is a word sort. So many students knows the meaning of sort. That's great. Let me take the name once again and let's see who else sends the meaning. Okay. So, Arhan, Ahmadullah Meiman, Albara Dori, Rajatava. Okay. So, sorting means to make or categorize our data. Categorize the data in some specific type. For example, in grocery store, you will only find the grocery. Will you find any furniture? No. Will you find any crockery? No. Will you find cars in the grocery store? No. You only find vegetables. The grocery you find because this shop is sorted. Okay. The bank. In the bank, there is a money. You will only find the money in the bank. It's sorted for the money. Okay. For example, there is an area for the business. In that business area, you will only find the shops. Specifically find the commercial area in which the businesses are going on. So that area is sorted. This is not the case that there are two houses, then there is one shop, then four houses, then five shops, then there are two houses, then six shops. This is not the case. Okay. So they put all the things at the same place. For example, when you go to purchase a tea leaves for the tea, you are purchasing a tea leaves. So they put all the things of tea at one shelf, normally in the shopping malls or they are near to each other. For example, along with the tea leaves, they put the sugar in the cabinets so that the person who is purchasing a tea, they can also purchase, if they want to purchase the sugar, they can purchase. And they can also put the some other things related to those tea accessories. Why they are putting it? They are sorting it out. They are sorting it out in a specific order. In the shopping mall, you will find it out. There is a specific portion for the clothes. There is a specific portion for the crockery. There is a specific portion for the electronics. There is a specific portion for the LCDs. There is a specific portion for the oil. There is a specific portion for the ready-made food. Why they make the specific portions? They sort. They make a category of a specific items in a mall so that people can find it easy to get their item. So this is a specific sorting. This is the explanation of sorting. Okay. Now, so very well done to those who give me the example, who give me the definition of the sort, who tell us the sort. Yeah, okay, it's okay. Okay, Ryan Abdul Salam, you are asking for a screen control screen. of my computer. Why you are asking? You are asking this a fourth or a fifth time. Don't ask me this thing again and again. I will never give the control. How many times I will tell you this thing? That don't ask me the screen control because I am not giving the control to any student. Very good. Arhan shared a very good example and the definition. The example is of shopping and the Arhan gave the definition. The definition is the arrangement of data in a prescribed sequence. Very good. Superb. Arhan did the splendid job. Very well done, Arhan. This is the exact definition. It's a technical exact definition of the sorting. The arrangement of data in a prescribed sequence. It's just a category. Arrangement of a things in a categorized form. This is a sorting. So the data can be sorted. Data can be sorted in any form. So everybody got an idea for the sorting?
Yes, sir.
Okay, that's great. That's great. Now the point is, I tell you this word in a so much detail. Why I tell you this word in the so much detail? Because this word, if you want to pursue your career, if you want to continue your career in the computer field, in the field of computer, in the data scientist or the data analyst, or in the field of computer science, if you want to pursue your career, then this word will come again and again. This word will come again and again. Which word? This is sort. This word will again come again and again in your routine if you pursue your career. Okay, because everything is sorted in computer, in database, in internet, everything is sorted. So that's why I explained this thing in the great detail. So now let me erase this arrow. Now what we have, so we discussed about the database. It helps us to find data easily from the thousands of records and files. It also allows us to make a category of data. For example, I am make a category of the students. Students of class 1, students of class 2, students of class 3. So these are the categories. I make a record of the students who got the 100 marks. I make a category of students who got the 95 marks. So in this way, we can sort the data and keep it up to date. I am making a data from a date records. How many students in this month got the highest marks? How many students in the previous month got the highest marks? So in this way, we can sort and up to date our data. We can create list of telephone numbers. We can create list of telephone numbers and addresses using database management software or program. As I told you, the software and the program, both terminologies, both terms used interchangeably. So we can create list of telephone numbers and addresses using database management software. For example, as I told you, you are taking admission in school or you are taking admission in any gym. So they took your telephone number. Why? To send you the message, send you the information, send you the new services. Okay. And they took your address for any future use. They put it up in the database and they can easily check that from that specific area, how many people are coming to this school. With the help of this database, we can easily check that, for example, there are four areas, A, B, C, and D. Let's suppose we have four areas in UNISA, A, B, C, and D. And now they are checking how many people are coming from the area B. They just search it. They can easily search it in the database that how many people are coming from the B. They can find it out that there are 50 students coming from that area. So they find out that 50 students of different classes are coming. Total number of students are 50. So then we will put the bus to that area that there are 50 students. And then they check how many students are coming from the area A. Then there are only 5 students coming.
So they will send the small car. They will send the small car for the 5 or 4 students because the database is showing that from the area A, 5 students are coming. And they will send the big bus to that area where the 50 students are coming. So with the help of database, we can decide the things. We can see the resources that where we have to use it. I gave you the example in this perspective that we can see with the help of database, we decide which bus will go. Big one will go to B area. The small bus will go to A area because of the number of students. So this is how the database is work. This is how the database is work. Remember, database can easily do the calculations, but the management of these calculations are very important because once the calculation lose, all data will be useless. So calculation and the management are both necessary for the database. Did you guys understand this point of data storage? Say yes or no.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
So, one more thing. Some students ask a question. I gave an answer in the chat. And right now, there is no question. But if you guys have any question, you guys just send the message in the chat. I'm also giving the answers to many questions. And I'm continuously checking your questions, whatever you are sending. So, Mohammad Hussain, yes, I know. Sort is a thing we can easily understand. But for the explanation, we need this thing. Mohammad Hussain shared a thought that he knows what is thought, what is sort. But he didn't get the proper words to explain. So it's okay. Mohammad Hussain, I believe you that you know it. And I know all of you, you guys are very much intelligent and you know it. But I explained the sort in this way that everybody got it. Ah, that's good. Mawaf, Fadi, Mohammad Hussain, Adam, and all the students, those who sent the definition and I took the name. Very well done. You guys have the good sense of understanding. You guys have good sense of understanding. Very good. Okay. So, we discussed about the MS Word. We discussed about the Microsoft Word. We discussed about the MS Excel. We discussed about the MS Access. So how many softwares which we see? There are 3. MS Word, MS Excel, and MS Access. So MS Word. In MS Word, what we do? In MS Word, we do the documents. In MS Word, we do the document. Let me write it here. In the MS Word, we make a document. Okay. So let me make it small so that it will be fit in the window. Okay. So MS Word is used to make documents. And MS Excel is used to make spreadsheets. Now, MS Access is used to make database. It's a DBMS. It's a DBMS. It's a database management system. The short form of database management software, the short form is DBMS. Database, DB is for database, M is for management, and S is for software. Sometimes we can say it a system, database management system or software. The S will stands in both. The S will stands in both. So we see these things in this chapter. Now, there is a line at the end. There is a line written at the end of this page. What does this line is saying? This line is basically saying the point that a file, okay. Let me raise the arrow first. Wait for a second. A file is a group of records that have something in common. So a file is a group of records that have something in common. So there is a common thing in between. For example, I make a file of class 1A. What is the common thing? The common thing is that every student is in the class 1A. If I make a file of class 4, the common thing is all the names right now in my chat, all the names right now in my chat is basically from the class 4. So in this way, the file is made. Whenever I am taking the class, when I am taking classes, the video is being recorded at the time of the lesson. But when the class is ended, when I go to the folder, I see the files in separate folders. Why? Because every class has a different video, but in common, all the things are in it. So a file which has a common thing, a file which has a common thing. For example, I make a file of the students. Those are coming from the area B. I make a file from a student, those who are coming from area A. Now I am making a file of the students who got the full marks of all the classes. Now I am making the list, those students who get the marks more than 95 and less than 100. I make a student of the list, I make a student list of those students, those who are participating in sports. I make a list of those students who participating in a soccer, in the football. So in this way, we can find it out. What is the common thing? The football is the common thing. The position is the common thing. The 100 marks are the common thing. The student who got the more than 95 marks and less than 100 is a common thing. So that's why on the basis of these, the file or the list are made in the databases. The file or the list are made in the databases. Okay, so we discussed about the MS Access database management program, its some tricks, and about the file. Now, along with it, everybody go to page number 40. Everybody go to the page number 40. Before going there, my question is, can we touch hardware of computer? What do you think? Can we touch hardware of computer? Yes or no? Means true or false? Yes means true. False means wrong. No means false or wrong. So what do you think? Can we touch the hardware of computer? Or can we simply say, can we touch the hardware? You can send the answer in chat so that I can get to know that who knows the real answer. Very good. That's great. Okay. So can we touch the hardware or not? Just say yes or no. Okay. Let me take a name. It's Ziad Salim, Arhan, Nawaf, Muhammad Fadi, Arhan, Amr Rayman, Fadi Muhammad, Rajatawa. Adam and Ryan Abdusalam. Muhannad Ahmad Siddiq. Very good. That's great. You guys give the correct answer. It's a yes. It's a confirmed yes. Okay, Ayad, you are very much right. That's great. Okay, so it's a confirmed yes. Jibrail, you are also right. So all the students give the correct answer. That it's a clear yes. The names which I took, all the students send the correct answer. Yes, we can touch the hardware. Now, my point is, hardware is a thing or a object which we can touch physically. We can touch the computer, yes. Mouse, yes. Keyboard, yes. Can we touch the CPU, yes. We can touch the monitor, yes. We can touch the hardware. Hardware is a physical thing. The thing which is touchable physically is a hardware. Okay. So now
we were discussing about the software. The name of the chapter is Ways Through Software. So can you tell me, or any one of you tell me, that can we touch the software? Can we touch the software or not? Very good, Ayad Ahmad, Nawaf, Fadi Muhammad, that's great. So my question is, can we touch the software or not? Can we touch MS Word? Can we touch the game? Can we touch the MS Excel? Can we touch the Facebook? Can we touch the Instagram? Can we touch the Snapchat? Can we touch the browser? Can we touch the MS Excel? Can we touch it or not? No, very good. That's great. So let me take the name of the student who give the correct answers. It's Ayad, Ayad Ahmad, Nawaf, Fadi, Amr Ayman, Abdul Rahman Hussain, Arhan, Rayan, Adam, Abdul Rahman Hussain, Amr Ayman, Tafim Zaman, Umar Muhammad, Fadi Muhammad, Abdul Rahman Nathir, and Muhammad Fadi. Excellent. You all guys give the correct answer, and the answer is no. We can't touch the software by the hand because it's a soft copy. It's inside the computer. We can visualize it. We can just see it. Yes, excellent. Amr Ayman share explanation for this. We can touch the hardware. What does Amr Ayman write? Amr Ayman write that we can touch the hardware, but we cannot touch the software, because if we try to touch it, we will touch the screen, and screen is a hardware. Excellent explanation, Amr Ayman. Excellent. Superb. You did the great job. Okay. So right now, before starting it, right now, the time of the period is finished and there is an assignment waiting for you in the class light. Everybody just open the assignment from the class light and do it. It's very easy. Okay, we are stopping it here. We will continue this lesson from this page 40 in the next class, inshallah. So, bye everyone, and have a nice day to everyone.
Bye, sir. Have a nice
day. Okay, thank you. Bye-bye, everyone.